Actually, in my honest opinion, I think that fall in New York City is the best season. You can wear the best clothes, the weather's perfect, the leaves are like not in prime sadly, but they're in the process of changing from green to like that very colorful fall season, which I love. But it's such a nice day today. It's like 60 and I'm bundled up, but I don't feel cold and I don't feel overwhelmingly hot, which is really, really good. I'm really enjoying the peaceful, serene view right now in Central Park. And being in New York is such a nice thing because you can go straight from walking in Times Square in the city to this sceneful, ceramic nature view in Central Park. And it's great having like the best of two worlds right at your fingertips. Right next to Central Park, there is this giant Apple store and I need to go in it because I ordered a MacBook not too long ago and I was supposed to get a $150 Apple gift card with it, but the Apple gift card, it's like not working and I don't know why. So I'm hoping that I'm gonna go in there and they're gonna like let me know what's wrong with it or hopefully give me a new one, because that's a lot of money to not be able to use. The New York City vlog off with shopping in Times Square, and honestly, not trying to buy anything really, but we're just gonna see what's out here just in case. So we're in Times Square right now, obviously, and we're going to go ahead and do some shopping. Honestly, it's really not that packed, and it's kind of surprising because Times Square is always like filled with so many people, but today it's not filled with that many people. If you've been to Times Square before, you know that it's always kind of crazy, but right now for 12:30 on a Saturday, it's like kind of popping off. There's like so much stuff going on. We saw a gorilla, a Batman, dudes are chanting in the background, dudes have microphones, which is all really normal, but for all of it to be happening right now in one enclosed area, it's weird. It's weird. So I've been to New York City at least like 100 times before, and never in my whole entire life have they like blocked off a street in the middle of Times Square for like markets. And it's just selling like markets, food, clothing, and things like that. But it's like my first time. Central location, but I'm a little bit annoyed, and I'm not like the type of person to get easily annoyed with like check-ins and things like that, but like every single person was checking in at 4 o'clock. It's like they didn't stagger their check-in times at all. And I've been to like so many hotels and Airbnbs, and this was the first time ever like I actually had to wait like such a long time to check in. I don't know if that's normal or not, and I've even checked in at hotels before in Times Square and in New York City, and it's like I've never had to wait that long ever to check in. And I don't know, know. If that's normal, let me know down below. But that was just really random to me.
But also with like the Apple Store, thankfully I was able to get the code because I thought I wasn't going to be able to get it. But I'm not sure what happened. I think they were supposed to send me an email and I never got that email. And the email I did got didn't have like the code that I needed it to have. So I was able to get that sorted out. So now I have the $150 Apple card. And if you bought like a MacBook or something near the end of September, you know what I'm talking about, which basically it was like, if you buy a MacBook, you'll get a $150 Apple gift card and you can use it for any Apple product. And I'm not quite sure what I want to use it for yet. But since we are in the room, let me go ahead and give you a little room tour. So you walk in and then on the left, you have the bathroom, which it's pretty normal. The shower's like a little bit tiny, but it's not terrible. And then we have the mirror with all of the good stuff that they left us, like shampoos, conditioners, and all that stuff. And then you come out and you have another mirror right here. And then this bed is ginormous, but what they did, they have two beds combined, which I'm starting to see is much more normal because I used to not see this at all. And now I've been seeing it like every single place ever in hotels and Airbnb and things like that. And then here's a TV with like some storage stuff, but we're only here for one night, so we're not gonna use it. And then and of course, the beautiful New York City view of someone's patio or balcony or whatever this is. And I'm hoping it's not like an outdoor nightclub bar type thing because I would be upset. So we're gonna find out later to see what it is. But that's a pretty nice view that we have up there.
So I'm not even sure if I mentioned this yet, but the whole reason we're in the city this weekend is to go see a concert, and we're going to see Sebastian Yatra. If you're not sure who he is, he's like a Spanish singer and he does pop music, and I love his music, so I'm so excited to go to that concert tonight. And I am the type of person who, when I'm like walking for like so long and spending the whole day outside, like even if I have something to do later in the day, I have to come home and I have to just change and relax. So that's why I'm like hanging out in like lounge around clothes right now, because we have been out so long today. We've walked like 20,000 steps so far, so I really need to like take a nap before this concert, because if I don't take a nap then I'm not gonna have fun. So I'll see you guys later and I'll let you know how the concert goes, because I am so excited. Next morning, it's like 8:45, and the concert last night was so good. He played every song I wanted him to play. The performance was really well. We had really good seats, and I was nervous about that originally because we were really high up on the balcony and I didn't think we were gonna have a really good view, but I could see everything and I was so happy about that. Like, everything from start to finish. Oh my gosh, it was so good. And it started at like 8:30 and it ended at like 10:30 after the concert. We went to McDonald's and we came back here. And I woke up this morning at like 7:30 and I do not feel tired, because I'm really happy about that, one, because I thought that I was going to be feeling super tired and drowsy and like I wouldn't have energy to do anything today, but I am just so happy with how well that concert went. Oh my gosh, like that concert was just so good. And I have a bunch of recorded videos on my phone, and this morning I woke up and I immediately just started rewatching them because I was that like obsessed with how well the concert performance actually was. But today, it is a really nice sunny day in New York City. It's supposed to be like 65, I think, today. And I'm not quite sure what Michael and Maya's plans are, because we have been to New York City so many times before. And we're at the point where like Times Square isn't really that fun. Manhattan really isn't that fun. But we are going to have breakfast first. And Michael actually just went to go pick us up some bagels. And I did ask him to get me a vanilla chai too. But sadly, the place doesn't have vanilla chai. And I'm not sure why. Like, why do places not have vanilla chais? Like, I do not like coffee. I hate iced coffee. And every time we go someplace and I just want a vanilla chai, they're like, we don't have that here. And I'm like, why not? But I did get this shirt yesterday. You can't really see it that well. It says Beach Beagle from Uniqlo yesterday, and I got it for $6 in Times Square. Do you guys know how much of a steal that actually is, a $6 shirt in Times Square? That's like pretty good quality from Uniqlo, because they always sell really good quality shirts. I got lucky.
Did you get the same one as I did?
Absolutely not.
Oh, wait, no, you got it.
These look like two completely different bagels. Do you see this?
This is what Michael's bagel looks like. It literally looks like two completely different bagels. Look how light the bottom is, and then look how dark the top is.
That was $10?
For this.
Just for that?
Yeah.
That's insane.
It's not normally that much. It's usually like three or four.
This is my outfit of the day. I got this jacket from Shein, and there were so many reviews online saying the jacket was like tight and it didn't fit right, but I got mine in an extra large and I absolutely love it. This turtleneck is also from Shein. These leggings are from Amazon. My shoes are from Nike, because every time I'm in the city, I need to wear comfortable walking shoes, because we're walking like at least 20,000 steps a day. And if I'm not comfortable, like, it's just going to be a bad day overall. And I'm matching with Michael, and we didn't plan this at all, but look at this. We got black, we got this. Look at us. Go ahead, give them your outfit of the day.
All right, so for my outfit of the day, I have Reebok shoes, Old Navy pants, got the shirt from Shein, I got the JanSport backpack.
Also, we have all our stuff in this JanSport backpack, like 2 days worth of clothes, because we just do not bring luggage with us. And thankfully, we're gonna give a shout out to Michael's back, because he carries us all for both days.
Needs to carry.
But truthfully, we really don't know what we're going to do today. We kind of planned on staying like the whole Sunday in the city, but we really don't have a plan. We're just gonna walk around and see if we find something. I really would like a coffee, but I'm not sure what type. I would like a vanilla chai or something like that. But we are about to check out of the hotel right now. It's like 11:30 and we're gonna check out at 12. And then we're just gonna walk around. We really don't have a plan, as I said before, but it's such a nice day. We kind of thought we were going to spend the whole day in the city, but like, because we don't have anything to do, we're just gonna wander around, and if we see something, okay, cool. But if like we don't see anything, we may just head out early. And that's such a plus for us, because I know so many people dream of like going to New York City, and it's like living in New York and living so close to New York City. Like, I feel like so many people underestimate the privilege that like New Yorkers have to just go to the city and being like, okay, the city's boring, I just want to bounce. So yeah, we're just gonna see what the
thank you.
imagine going to New York City with your girlfriend. You go to Bryant Park and you start playing some games. You play some chess. And then you just put her in a checkmate for no reason. For no reason.
Hey, you're trying to do it to me.
And now we're on our way to the best restaurant in New York City. The food is amazing. It's cheap. It's affordable. And it has the best pizza in all of New York City. Two Brothers, if you know what I mean, you know how good it is. And I still have one more slice. Michael and I go back to the city, we always park at Secaucus Junction, and it's normally like $24 to park for a whole 24 hours, and Michael just went to go pay for the parking, and I see him coming back surprisingly quickly. So I don't know if that's a good thing or if that's a bad thing. Did you pay it?
No.
Oh, I was just saying you were coming back surprisingly quickly. I didn't know if that was a good or bad thing.
No line.
We're actually on our way home right now, and it's going to be like a 4-hour drive. It is like 3:00 right now, and I'm thinking we're going to be back at around 7:30 or 8, depending if we make a stop or not, or if there is traffic. It doesn't seem like there's going to be a lot of traffic, so let's hope it stays that way, because city traffic is bad, but traffic going in and out of the city can be equally as bad depending on the day, and it is a 3-day weekend, and that could just make things completely more terrible.